Let's talk about the voice of the customer model and where customer advisory boards fit. It's important to understand where a customer advisory board fits in relationship to things like product focus groups and surveys. There's the right tool for the right job. And a lot of times, sometimes these meetings or different types of engagement pieces get confused with each other. So I built this pyramid model to explain where things fit. So let me describe this to you briefly. As you can see on the model, on the left-hand side, y-axis, has tactical topics versus strategic topics. Now, this is not to say that strategic topics are more important than tactical topics. It's just to indicate that depending on the type of topic, different questions are asked to different people in your customer base. And we need to understand what those questions are because we want to match the right tool to the right job to engage in the right type of conversation. So starting at the bottom, you'll notice that the base of the pyramid is the widest there for customer input. This is the base of the pyramid for tactical and operational feedback, customer feedback. Now, this is where things like customer surveys can fit in, social media, any kind of feedback form or interaction that might be happening from a customer support organization, maybe through sales, maybe some marketing. The base of the pyramid is wider there, because it indicates that many people within your company will be engaging with many customers at any given time. There's lots of interaction, there's lots of discussion going on all the time, and that's captured at a very tactical level. Now, from a type of questions, this could be, I had a bad experience on Tuesday. What are you doing to fix it? It's very tactical, it's very timely, it's very real-time nature type of conversation. Okay, that's at the bottom, the base of the pyramid. You move one level up, that's what I call product direction. Now, this fits what I call kind of a short to midterm type product roadmap perspective. Think in terms of your roadmap that's maybe 6 months out to 18 months out. Now, you're not going to be developing brand new products necessarily within this window, but you'll be tuning the products that you already have, or you'll be working on the next dot release. So a lot of your investment has already been made, but you want some help from customers to help tune directionally where the products might go. So the 6 to 18 month window is a good one. Now, this is where your traditional product focus group would happen. CABs sit on top. They are the top of the pyramid, and that indicates that not your entire universe of customers will participate, and not even a smaller set that would come to your focus groups. It's a much more elite set of customers, and here we're talking about a dozen, maybe 10 to 12 of your C-level decision makers come to have a strategic conversation with your executive staff. Now, these questions are in the nature of where your customer's business is going. Customers, how is the market evolving from you? Where are you going to be investing 3 years from now? What's your technology stack going to look like? What kind of things is it going to do? What are you going to outsource? What are you going to insource? What are the biggest gaps in your ability to execute your technology or innovation strategy moving forward? Those are examples of potential strategic questions that you would ask at that C-level leadership position in your customers, right? Those would not be the same questions or the same people you would address in the real-time customer feedback at the bottom of the pyramid. So again, we've got this distinction between tactical topics versus strategic topics. And at each layer, we're talking real-time at the bottom, 6 to 18 months for the product direction. At the advisory board, you're looking at 18 months to 3 years out because you want to get ahead of the curve. You want to know where customers are going so you can meet them there. So when you think of your own voice of the customer strategy, what I encourage you to do is build your own pyramid model. And you've seen what mine looks like generically. It might be an interesting exercise for you and your colleagues to see if you can identify what tools, what engagement models, what questions you're asking which members of your customer base at various times during this interactive pyramid model. I hope you find that helpful.